this is upside down today.
Yeah.
Which I like. Because I'm talking to everybody.
So the next step, you're going to place arrows to represent the direction of those interactions. So, for example, if I call you all the time, it would be me to you. If you call me all the time, it would be you to me. If we call each other, it would be an arrow to both of us. And the last step, draw circles around any cliques. So like any, if there's a small set of people that they kind of are a set group of people, you can draw circles around them. If there's not any, then you don't have to draw any circles.
What about people viewing that they had the same kind of influence on my decision?
No, more about how they interact with each other. Like, are they,
do they know each other, their friends?
Yes, and the clique is kind of like a set group of people that interact together, and there's not a lot of other people that they let in and out of that group. Alright, are you happy? Is everything where you want it to be? Individuals you've listed on your system graph.
Well, I guess I'm going to write them out that whole album. My grandmother and my cousin. There are more people I just went to seek some advice, but at the same time, they didn't have much to say about what would have happened or which college I'm going to. But my grandmother, I did go to know a lot, and she came to know a lot in the trials with me. That's why they admit to. My best friends, they went through all the process of me being stressed. So they never really come back to me because they're not in the same situation. They're in very different situations, but they're my best friends, and I always go to them for advice, and they'll tell me what they think will be best for me. But at the same time, even if they show me that they only have any much influence on what I should do. Then there is my cousin, she got me excited about the school because it was her school too. So I was like, oh gosh, we're all going to ask you. And at the same time, she came back too, so we actually together somehow. And my brother, him, he was more of do as mom tell you and I understand you. So I would go to him for advice and he'll come back to me for what I should do. So when he had to sit in all this, he would have a baby. Like, he was very influential. My other brother said, he was more of a find the inside yourself. Because only you know what you should do. While my other brother was more of a do what mom tells you to do. Because she's going to be paying for it for me. My mom, she also took me to the whole process, but I wouldn't say that I did go to her, but at the same time, she was just telling me what to do. That's not it. And my uncle, because he was the one who told my mom about me right now, and he was the one asking me, telling me, oh, did I do this? Did I do that? I didn't really want to go to him, but let's say that he really did.
Okay, so your uncle talked to you about UNF. Did your uncle talk to your mom about UNF? Okay, and then you went to your cousin.
Yeah.
But did your cousin kind of?
Not really.
Okay, you were asking questions about it and that sort of thing. Okay, good. Well, thank you for giving me an overview of who you put where and why. Who did you talk to you about kind of the financial aspects of college?
My mom and my uncle. Yes, mom and my uncle. Because that was the first time that I had to feel. And we were figuring out if my uncle thought that I should be on campus. They were trying to figure out that if I was on campus, it was going to be way more expensive. My mom didn't want me to go on campus. So, to the financial point, it was more of, yeah, my mom.
Okay. What about the academic aspects of college? Did you talk to anybody about that?
Actually, no. I don't talk much about it. Not because I'm struggling and I think that I should be on myself. No, I seek help when I need it. But because there's not much to say. Let's say that I stepped easily. For example, yesterday I had an 80, and when I get 80s, even though it's not true, like I'll go on crying sometimes or get very overwhelmed because I feel like I should have had more, even though I understand why I didn't have that much. But people say that 80 is really good. Well, let's put that in perspective. In Haiti, an 80 is awesome. If I had an 80 on Haiti, I would have been thrilled. That's actually what happened like the last couple years of Haiti. I was trying to get an 80 as an average for all my classes. The farthest I got was like 79. But it's really hard to get there, but here it's kind of very easy to get to 100. So I get very upset when I do not get 100. But if I don't understand something, I just ask the teacher or I ask my peers. And I'm doing pretty great so far. I don't have much to complain about. I didn't like my chemistry teacher so far. I did tell somebody about that and they suggested I should drop out. But I'm good to find the class, I don't say to drop out because of the teacher that's insane.
Okay. What about the social aspects of college? Did you discuss that with anyone from here that you listed here?
Yeah, my brothers and my best friends. I don't have any friends. It's kind of upsetting because I used to have a lot of friends when I was here. But here it's kind of harder because everything's online. And I feel like to get friends, you actually have to be with the person. Let's say that. What I noticed from last semester to this semester is that some people will talk to you during the semester and then you can just fall out of touch.
Okay. So why did you place